Systems research is 1% inspiration and 99% perspiration. The only way to convince someone of your ideas is to build a system and evaluate it. Now, how do you go about evaluating a system such as Spin or Exokernel? You can qualitatively argue that you're achieving extensibility without sacrificing safety simply by the way the system is constructed. But you also have to show that you're not losing out on performance due to the extensibility hooks. There is an interesting dilemma when you're reading research papers. How do you make sense out of the quantitative results from a data research paper? When you read such papers, remember that absolute numbers are meaningless. It is the trends that are meaningful. While doing any performance study of a new system that you're proposing, you have to identify what the competition is. Remember that Spin and Exokernel were done in the early to mid-90s. For Spin and Exokernel, the competition is a monolithic operating system and a microkernel-based operating system. And the competition at that time for both Spin and Exokernel was Unix as a monolithic example and Mach from CMU as a microkernel example. And the performance questions always center around space and time. For example, how much better time-wise is the extended kernel, whether it is a Spin approach or the Exokernel approach, compared to a microkernel-based approach in terms of performance? And since we know an extended kernel may have to incur loss of locality and border crossing overhead and so on compared to a monolithic kernel, another question that we may want to ask is the extended kernel at least as good as a monolithic kernel? What is the code size of implementing a standard operating system, say Unix, as a monolithic operating system or a microkernel-based operating system or an extended kernel operating system? So that's the space question. So we can have time questions as well as space questions when we propose a new way of doing any particular system component. I encourage you to read the performance results in the papers. Key takeaway that you will see when you read the performance results reported by both Spin and Exokernel is that they do much better than Mach microkernel for protected procedure call. That is, when you go from one protection domain to another, how well are you doing? For that, both Spin and Exokernel exceed the performance of Mach. And you'll also see that both Spin and Exokernel do as well for dealing with system calls as a monolithic kernel does.